The last job I had, and you know, all that. I've kind of been going through a transformation of sorts. A little bit intentional, a little bit. Well, actually, no, fully intentional, but it's been a complicated process, and I kind of wanted to talk about it, partially because I feel like it's a bigger change in my life, and it's one of the things I would like to express and talk about in a way to, you know, just open up and have more conversations about it. But also too, because it kind of involves something I want to do with my channel, which is talk about clothing and fashion and the sort of separation and integration of those two things. So I figured with this first video, why not kind of start in a safer area and talk about, I guess what you could say, my clothing. And I say clothing very specifically. I would say I wanted to look good before all of this. I definitely like had an idea of how I wanted to look and an intention in things I was buying and getting, but I don't think in a proper sense I would call any of the clothing that I really bought before all of this fashion in a truly proper sense. My main directives were always about cost. I wanted to get stuff that was cheap, inexpensive, affordable. I did aim for quality, but there were a lot of times where I ended up getting something lesser because it was more affordable. And actually, these pants I'm wearing are a fairly good example of like a middle ground of this. So I love these pants, actually. I'm keeping them. They're kind of a dark gray and black houndstooth pattern. They look a bit like a wool knit. They're actually acrylic. And hey, they're one of the few pants I have that actually fit my waist properly. Not too baggy where I need a really tight belt. And they're also not like too tight where they're squishing everything. This, I think I got these like 2008. I feel like I've had them a really long time. So possibly when I was 18, maybe 20. They're definitely like a TJ Maxx buy, I think. Even though they are Hagar, which could place them in like JCPenney territory, but I don't think I got these on JCPenney. But I really love them. They're so cute. This top, I literally have no clue where I bought it. But I remember seeing it was like the only one on the rack. It was so unusual. It's like a full button up. It can go, well, I say full. It goes like up to here, and then you just have like this. But honestly, especially since being in the gym and such, I'm a slut. So there are just days where I love to wear this full-on tits out. And it was so unique. Considering I bought this in like one of my modest phases where I wasn't even like wearing short sleeves in public, let alone anything else. This was a bold buy for me, and I really love it, and I still have not really found anything majorly resembling this kind of cut, which is one of the reasons I like to keep it around. And yeah, I'm probably going to hold on to this until it's threadbare and falling apart, to be honest, but yeah. Going back, like, I bought a lot of clothing, functional stuff, and yes, there were little perks, like this sexy-looking thing right here that I love, but I think that one of the biggest differences to me between clothing and fashion is intention. And fashion, I'm not going to say that fashion never has form, it never has function, it never has purpose. Obviously, that's bullshit. But I think that the big separation is that the appearance and the utilization of different aspects and the presentation of fashion is front and foremost in the product. Whereas with clothing, the intention is the foremost thing. The function is foremost. Like, if you're getting a business shirt, just like cheapest, lowest budget, You want the buttons, you want the collar, you want it to be relatively nice in the seams, and everything else is secondary. It could be like really bad, low quality cotton that you wouldn't even find on like cheap bed sheets. It could be excessively thick and sort of hard to manage. It could be the wrinkle resistant stuff that, doesn't manage to actually be wrinkle resistant, but also is excessively fake feeling and smoothish. There's like a lot of variety to it. And I'm not going to say that anything that's clothing is inherently bad, but when you're buying it, you aren't exactly buying it for the same experience and getting the same things out of it as you would for a piece of fashion. Not to jump ahead in my storyline here, but this is one of those things I'm considering selling on Poshmark. I do have a Poshmark now. Poshmark is actually something I'm going to talk about further on in this little series because I feel like it is a fully separate and evolutionary step in this whole sort of clothing journey, so I want to focus on that separate from the other stages of this series that I want to make about clothing and fashion. But this is basically who I am as a fancy person, really. This shirt is a J.R. Ferrer. It is totally the wrong size. I don't know why I did this. I'm like a 15 and a half neck. This is 16 to 16 and a half. It is so loose. I low-key hate this collar. Okay, I am very much a tie person. I love ties. So most of these shirts, my little fancy button-ups I got, were from around the age of like 22 to 26 while I was still into college here. And I liked dressing up every day. I liked going in looking good, feeling fancy, feeling, nice. And that did tailor off a little bit as I start going to the gym at the school more because, I'm walking all the way to the school, going to exercise, going to my classes, going to another class, combining all this stuff, going to eat and such. So I didn't exactly want to like sweat through an outfit. And, so ultimately for me, a really big thing was feeling dressed up, feeling nice when I was going to school. And tops like this were some of my favorite. Nothing fancy, again. Like, this is J. Farrar, JCPenney.com stuff. And I always bought on clearance when I could, or on sale. And, I mean, with JCPenney, it's usually both. Like, if there was one of those coupons where you get so much percent off if you spend this much money, I was going to spend that much money to get that full discount. And honestly, I do like the print of this. It's not really a print. It's like fully integrated into the fabric, I think. Let's see here. Yeah, pretty much. It's fully integrated, so not really a print. But honestly, I always knew these shirts were kind of awful. And I'm gonna untuck it. So I have always had a thing where I like clothing that is more fit to my form. You probably noticed this. Even my gym clothes are more on the tight, slutty side than anything. But this to me has always been a problem with these shirts. And one of the reasons why I'm not really going to miss any of them as I slowly evacuate them from my wardrobe. So look at all of this extra fabric. And, I'm not saying I want every shirt to be skin tight, but look at this. This is me bunching it all back to like sort of actually fit my torso here. And this is how much extra there is. Why am I bringing this up? Specifically because of the fact that this shirt is sort of like an ultra slim build. I can't even remember what. I think they called it extra slim or something. And granted, again, like this shirt is the wrong size. Like I said before, it's like a large, so I should expect that to some degree. But let's see, yeah. Super slim fit. And the thing is, this one's a large, but I have others that were mediums I ordered the wrong size. Same problem. So huge and big with the fabric, with the extra stuff there. And the whole reason I was buying super slim is because I don't like that extra fabric. I don't like that billowiness. I want my clothes to fit. So, yeah, these, they're pretty. I like them. The fabric was nice, pretty good, but I am definitely not looking back on these. It's going to pick up because it's not too bad, but I just noticed there's a stain on this shirt, so I was holding on to this. I thought it would be like cute to have as a bit, but nah, if it's got that stain on it, I'll see if I can remove it and then resell. If not, this is going straight into donation bins and they can deal with it. Yeah, but this shirt to me represents another issue I have with clothing. And again, I'm saying clothing in a very specific way. So this shirt is Dickies brand. I also got a JCPenney, also on sale, etc. But also too, it is blue. And this shirt is also blue. There are about 5 other shirts in my old rotation of clothing that are all blue. Why so many blue shirts? I was working at Kmart. So 2004 into 2005, not as long as it sounds because it was like late 2014, late 2014 to early 2015. I was working at the local Kmart and it was a bit of a stressful job. It was a bit hectic and such, and it was very much one of those jobs where you had a set thing that you had to do, but also we're going to ask you to do about 500 other things because we somehow managed to always be understaffed, and the idea of you having a moment's rest is horrific. Horrific. I fucking love these. These are some of my favorite pants. These are Arizona. They're like faded gray and such, and scrapey, hollow knees. My mom was always one of those people like, oh, why would you want to buy jeans with holes in them? Because they look sexy. And like, there's so many better jeans I could have out there, like Balmain, beautiful, like destroyed stuff. But until I can afford a pair of those or find a nice pair for cheap, these are my go-tos, and I gotta say, I love them. Like, they have such a cheap quality to them. There's so much stretch in this denim, it's ridiculous. But I love them. But yeah, outside of the fact that I had to have black pants for that workplace, everything up here just had to be blue, and not even a standard blue, hence variety. So I had an enormous love affair with that job because I had my different shirts, I was pairing them with different ties. If I was feeling a little fat one day, I could wear a waistcoat over it. They said like a little bit of overwear was okay, so I grabbed those and loved them. I had nice old belts. I was living. And honestly, I was sad when I lost that job. There was a long dry spell where I didn't have any work, even though I was putting in applications regularly in town. Then I got my McDonald's job, which was like my longest ever, for like 4+ years, almost 5 years at that job. And I won't say I loved it. I didn't hate it either. I hated it in the end, but that's because there was a full new manager and the standard of the workplace just collapsed. But yeah, that job, the job after that was a little bit better because it was reverse Kmart. You had to wear their shirts, but you could basically wear anything as pants as long as they were, you know, respectable, no holes, etc. So it was a little bit of a reverse. I didn't have as much stuff, but I liked having that little bit of expression, but I was hungry for more. And yeah, basically so much of my old wardrobe was constructed around the idea of, you know, where I worked as well. Like this. Last major thing I'm going to show off like this. This is just a, oh my God, is it peeling already or is that just like laundry stuff? This little shirt here is Lion's Heart brand, I think, whatever that is. It was a Burlington Coat Factory buy, and I think, too, this is emblematic of the way I kind of wanted fashion, but between my price points, my bargain hunting, and my more sort of utilitarian-ish approach to clothing overall, I didn't really do anything properly bold or outlandish with it. So it's just a basic long sleeve V-neck t-shirt from this company with little epaulettes, little shoulder things here. And I love features like this. A lot of stuff I have that I've already done away with and stuff from previous wardrobe overhauls in my life had little features like this. And a lot of it was weirdly useless in a way. And I say that not in the sort of sense like, oh, it doesn't really have a function or anything, but I never properly utilized any of these things. Like I've said before and such in fitness videos and in stuff like this, I had a very long modesty period where I was covering myself up a lot. Like, I won't lie, this shirt, even just this, which is very modest and covering and not anything special to me now, this probably would have had a jacket over it, zipped. This probably would have had something else thrown over it, and, you know, something thrown over it that would cover up this detail. I had other ones that had, like, really nice little straps for when you rolled up the sleeves, but I never rolled up my sleeves because I didn't want to have any bit of my arm visible. So everything was always buckled up down here, buckled up here. I had shirts that looked really, really cute in certain ways. But again, I was usually wearing a coat or something or a hoodie. So all these little details and such on things would get covered up. And that's one of the things I really have slowly started to move away from. And I want to move away from even more. I still definitely have a lot of issues around my body shape and body image. I'm not exactly like where I want to starve myself to a six-pack anymore, but I would just like to get rid of a little bit extra of the stuff here to, like, not look a certain way, but just to not have so much of it get squished in and puffed out when I'm actually wearing clothes. I think I've said this before in other stuff, but, like, it's not so much I have a problem with how I look naked, it's how I look in certain clothing that's the issue. And I think that was a really overwhelming thing through my body dysmorphia periods, through my extreme starvation, trying to be skinny era, and all of that. But yeah, this is kind of emblematic of a lot of things that I went through and things that I really had to work to abandon. Before we get into the rest of this perfectly, I figured one last look, because I kind of forgot that through all the transitional episodes of my wardrobe, there's been one thing to remain constant. So, I kind of mentioned this a little bit before, but, like, 16, now before that even, like, 14 onward, because I was listening to a lot of Japanese music and such, I was very much into the Kodona aesthetic, the sort of elegant gothic aristocrat look, and of course in general a wider range of visual kei styles. And I bought a lot of stuff off, like, not Yes Asia, what was the other one, J-pop something, Japanese music website that also did like a sideline of clothes and such. They had Mamami Moite on there, Sexpot Revenge, Algonquin, and a few other of those sort of visual punk style bands. I'm not sure if this is the one, but take a look. Vinyl Syndicate, the magazine that was being put out by Sexpot Revenge, the clothing brand as well. Look at this. It has a full little CD and it's still in there. I don't know if I ever opened it, actually. Ooh, should I? I don't know. But yes, getting stuff from this was just like so much fun. Looking at these clothes, oh my god. But ah, yes. And, yep. This stuff was, and funnily enough, looking at it, like, I could see the microcosm of, like, this specific style and such, but I'm also seeing in a lot of ways how this reflected into my own style. Even right now, just this sort of basic outfit. You guys can't really see them, can you? But these jeans are actually a very late thrift for me. Not thrift, late buy. It was in a TJ Maxx or a Ross in Santa Fe. I'm on my very last trips in 2019, just before lockdown. There's some Abercrombie and, what is it? Abercrombie and Fitch? Abercrombie and Lilo and Stitch? But yeah, there's some of those jeans, you know, the sexy place with the beautiful men on the bags and everything. But I just spent so much of my youth drooling over their whole aesthetic. And then I saw these, and I was like, hey, you know what? I'm gonna grab them. And I love them. They're like a size too small for me. They have like no stretch into denim, so they're very unforgiving. But I really, really like them. But yeah, this little tie right here just symbolizes so much of my whole fashion journey. This is the oldest thing. It has been through hell and back. It has been so abused. There's a stain right there. It's missing its entire little thing in the back. The stitching on it is awful. But I'm probably never going to get rid of this because it just is a staple. And from about 2008 at the least, because of that magazine, that would place this as one of the oldest things still in my wardrobe at this time. I didn't really get to talk about shoes too much because, again, like, going through all of that, a lot of my shoes were utilitarian, more function and not so pretty. And lacing was a big thing for me. It still is, actually. Lacing is a great way to style up any kind of shoe, and I stand by that. But in terms of adventurous shoe purchases, within this era of my clothing style, the biggest departure would have to be these old bad boys. You've probably seen them before. I've worn them in other videos and such. Actually, I wore this shirt in my Going to LA Pride videos, too. So, 2019, a year into making videos for the first time. This was my very first vacation in ages. And yeah, I wore this shirt to the airport, actually. Funny. And then I bought these shoes at Macy's. They're ink. They're polyurethane. I'm ashamed of myself, but... All right, inside the closet. So, everything up here we can ignore for now. That's for later. Except for some of it, but I'll get into that. And honestly, I put up some things here that probably don't belong, but for most of all, this rack here and the pants below it, this is the old guard. The clothes that I'm kind of phasing out, keeping some, but mostly represents that whole era of me buying clothing as opposed to wanting to buy fashion. But honestly, some of these pieces are a look. I still love this. Definitely gonna keep this thing. So, a low V with these extra little buttons that add a little bit extra. I think I've worn it unbuttoned maybe one time, but like, the buttonholes are really thin, a little bit raw, so it's not really made to be opened and closed, but it just, ugh. Before I bought the JJ Malibu deep V cuts, this was my original little bad boy, and I love this thing. This technically counts. Again, this is like late 2019 when I was finally starting to do trips and everything, but I had to get this Dorian Electra shirt. I love it. But honestly, I'm going to count that as a departure. Well, this is an oldie. I don't know when I bought this. Rebel Minds, this label is coming off already. I wish they would print years on some of the tags for clothing. This was a size small. I remember they had a medium and it fits so large. But I love this thing. It's got these actual, like, sort of painty splotches all over it. It's an interesting feeling on them. And I know you're not supposed to dry clean it, but I don't know what it is. And then this, like, gold epaulette accent on here. And it's also down the sides, too. But, again, because I was always wearing a jacket over something or something long-sleeved over, so many of the features of this top have just never properly been shown off. So, one of those things I definitely need to fix. I have a bunch of empty hangers in here for some reason. Probably because I was grabbing stuff off the hangers to show off over there and I forgot. And one of the more recent aspects of me shopping at these clothes, and stuff that you guys have probably seen in videos I'm wearing, is the short sleeve button up. And I am very particular about these in polos, because the sleeve has to fit. It has to be tight. It has to show off the arms. So these are something I actually have not really bought a lot online lately because it's really hard to guarantee the proper fit. And there's a few that I did buy and you can see where the problem is, in at least in terms of my idea of ideal fit. But these were ones I got to try on. So I do have a very nice little soft spot for these, especially since I've been wearing them in videos. And yeah, I'm probably going to hold on to most of them. I have such a weak spot for this one. It is loud, annoying. It has two cons on it. This one is really cute, though, with the little birds. And it's just denim and flower. But I think it is really sweet, and it fits nice. This dark blue one with the rolled-up cuff that has an accent in black. All cotton, very lovely. I really like this one. This very much fits in the same category as the gray and black striped hoodie, where I bought it because I thought it was sexy and unique. And I'm probably going to hold on to it for a long time because I still feel that way. I ended up finding this at TJ Maxx in, I think, Albuquerque. It's got these nice little red cuffs with this epaulette detail where it folds up and buttons it. And it has the buttons only down to about like a 3/4 area. Let's see. It would be like mid-stomach. So I'd like to undo maybe one, two buttons, let the rest like hang out a bit. And then the rest out here is all smooth. And I do love that geometric pattern on it. But this is kind of a weak one for me. I just have got to hold on to that until I can find like a equivalent in a much fancier. This little shirt, again, this is a TJ Maxx, but I absolutely love the little floral design here. And I don't know if I can get it close enough for you to see the detail, but in some of the flowers right here, there are like little skulls, which, you know, my aesthetic. But I do sour on this one because the collar on it is so thin, it's really hard to wear with a tie. This one is a Van Heusen. It's nothing fancy, but it does fit my neck actually, which makes it better than any of the J.F. Ferrer shirts I still have around. Collar is good, and I do like the fabric. It's one of these like travel ready, so it's probably a polycotton blend, if I remember correctly. Yeah, 60% cotton, polyester, and a little bit of spandex. But it's a really nice fabric. It's not thick, it's not thin. It has held up really nice, and I'm probably not going to keep this shirt forever, but I feel like it has a few more wears and functions to it. Oh, I love this baby. Oh, poor thing, the sleeve came. This is one of those ones, again, that just has like a slightly different little detailing when the cuff is rolled up. And this one fits so good. Like, it is a little bit billowy in the waist. It has like a nice snug feeling in the chest and the arms. Maybe I could skip the gym for a month and these arms are still going to just fit lovely. So yeah, this shirt, I love her so much. Going back into my blue phase I mentioned before, this one is starting to get little snags and such. So she's probably on limited shelf life, but it has like these beautiful, if you can see it in the camera, these beautiful little details of like roses and such. And well, where did that stain come from in the back? Okay, yeah, this shirt is probably ready to go. I would miss it. It does have that weak collar, but I really do love it, though. Like, these little details in the appliques. I'll see if I can get that stain out. If I could, this would be, like, I'll keep it in my collection maybe a few more months or such. But honestly, the one problem with polyester, cheaper polyester especially, is it weaves like this and knits like this, it will snag and get caught in things. I'm not going to trash all polyester because I have seen some good stuff, especially in more designer clothing too. But all in all, yeah. So SQ wear, I don't know about. This was like a TJ Maxx purchase again. It's fully cotton though. Very nice. No stains this time. It does have that sort of sheer printing on it where it doesn't go through all the fabric, which I think leads to a little bit more fading and such, but I don't know. I feel like I've seen some fabrics where the print is just as strong as one side as the other, and that's the kind of thing I tend to lean towards now. But I do love this. It has like this really soft, subtle little flower pattern on it that is lovely. The collar is a good size. It holds, ties really well. And then two little TJ Maxx purchases. I just love sweaters. I love cardigans. And I love a shawl collar. So having these two, yeah. It's just St. John's Bay and Claiborne, so nothing fancy. But I definitely will hold on to these until it's time to replace them. And then I've been wearing a lot of these since starting my job at the hotel. But again, all these are JCPenney versions. It's just J.R. Ferrer. Is this J.R. Ferrer too? I think it is. The tag is in a different place. Yes, it is. J.F. Ferrer. And this one too. Yeah. Oh dear, that button is dying for release. I need to sew that up. But yeah, basically, I love a good waistcoat. These are all good. There's more I have. Like, there's basically the same. It's like this, but with a larger print. But I want to get more from different brands. It's such as a really pretty Giorgio Armani one in one of my wish lists. But, yeah. This is also Lion's Crest that I showed off the V-neck for. I got this at the same time. There's also one in gray that's in storage right now. But it's like a sweater with this. I am slightly annoyed with it because the way this collar is cut, it's like really close to a tie. So you can't really show it off too well. I love this thing. So it's a blackjack hoodie, little pullover thing. But it has like this extra little collar on it that's like a cowl neck. And I've always loved those. This was like $50 at TJ Maxx. And I won't lie, I scraped off a clearance tag from something else and put it on this in the dressing room. And I got this for like $19.99. I'm ashamed of myself, but... And then this doesn't really count. This is more interim, and I'm going to get into this later, but it's a JJ Malibu hoodie, and yeah, literally just that. This little bitch, I think she was at Alco, the store here, and it's basically just a generic, very soft, thin fabric hoodie. Good for summer, good for, you know, covering up, which I was doing. And it, again, has these really nice little detailed buttons where... It sits pretty good when they're buttoned, but if you open it up, it's a little bit whore, and I love that. Like I was saying before, just to wrap things off, pretty much everything over here is my old guard. Oh yeah, I forgot about these. I also have my old jackets. I put them over here just because, you know, I'm not exactly going to be replacing jackets anytime soon, but just this little bitch in corduroy. I don't know, I feel like this was a TJ Maxx purchase. Let's see here. This jacket is South Pole, evidently. I had one in black, but I left it too close to a space heater one winter, and it actually got fully dried out and a little bit burnt and cracked. Like, it literally, the back of the sleeve cracked open, so... Don't leave your denim jackets next to space heaters, is the moral of that story. This little bitch is cute, functional... Triot, I don't know, but... And really nice, thick denim. Not a lot of stretch in it, which is nice. Finally, in the jacket front, there's this one, which has, like, that motorcycle jacket collar, where it's, like, sort of a Nehru, but just the zippers on. And I do, I adore this one. And then also, too, I just bought this because I thought it was cute. It's, again, one of the... last TJ Maxx purchases I made in like 2019 and such, but it's a fully like polyester little Pac-Man shirt with the name in katakana and his little print there. I love this. I sadly did wear it out in the rain once and found out it was not waterproof. There is at least one piece up here that I have kept separate because, first of all, it's special. I've worn it a lot, but it is... this little pride piece, Levi's. And mainly because Levi is one of the brands that I've been buying stuff from. And this shirt, like, it matches up with the quality of the other stuff I've been buying. And it just has, like, a soft spot for me. And, you know, I'm not going to get too much into this stuff now. But I will say that it's been a very mixed journey because I am still shopping functional. I am still shopping in terms of use because... At first, it was more about building a base wardrobe, and then I got my job recently as a concierge front desk at a hotel in town, and it's free dress, so I get to wear what I want, mostly. And I won't lie, like, well, a lot of this started out as, like, a base wardrobe. The expansion of it has definitely been built on my job, which, on the one hand, is a little bit frightening, because that's kind of what happened before with all the blue... And I don't want to stray into that territory too much, but I also do like it. Mostly because I've been fortunate enough that a lot of the stylistic things that I'm interested in kind of fall into the category of being really good for this. But I do want to make videos in future going into things like that, especially sort of more traditional men's style. Like I've mentioned ties now. There's shirts here I bought specifically because I could wear them with cufflinks And I dipped into vintage four more shirts with cufflinks. And there's other things, tie pins, lapel pins. And I've just noticed that there is not a lot of room inside the sort of trad male fashion realm for queer representation, for flamboyancy, for, true self-expression, really. It's incredibly restrictive. And I would like to be able to have stuff that delves more into that, into that openness and the aspects of fashion that are modern and now and free of all those holdings and tie downs, etc. But yeah, basically, this kind of concludes the first chapter of this little saga. This was me as someone who bought clothing, and I actually realized this shirt is too big again. This is another 16, 16 and a half, but I have such a weak spot for it. And again, I'm gonna try to get close, but it's like a traditional plaid with little skeletons on it. So I love her. And again, I'll probably replace it at some point, but I'm kind of not in any hurry to. But yeah, so over the next few, however long it takes me to put together these videos, I want to delve into this realm and separate this because I want to talk about the new stuff and the old stuff. So I feel like there's like going to be a fully separate video for Poshmark. And not to self-advertise or anything, but I do have a Poshmark account. I am selling some of this stuff on that Poshmark account eventually. I want to talk about clothes and fashion and the transitions between the two. And I think that's kind of going to be where I'm going for now. Well, I still have like a passion, invested interest in it, and it'll feel less like I'm just making content to make content, if that makes sense. But yeah, if you enjoyed this video, like, comment, subscribe. I will see you guys in the next one. Of course, remember, life always gets better as long as you work at it brick by brick. See ya.
Good night, until we meet again. Adios, au revoir, I'll be the same till then. And though it's always sweet sorrow to part,
you know you'll always remain in my heart.
Good night, sleep tight, and pleasant dreams to you. Here's a wish and a prayer that every dream comes true. And now, till we meet again, adios, au revoir, I'll be the same. Good night.
This program is made possible by
Ed Oakley
and by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.